Hey guys, welcome to Pursuit Kids on the Line. We are so excited that you're joining us this morning. I'm Miss Irene.
And I'm Miss Carrie, and it's my most favorite time of the week. It's time to worship. So get ready to stand to your feet, get ready to lift your hands and dance with us, because worship starts now.
Yeah.
Hey preschoolers, this week we're going to learn the story about Stephen and how he boldly proclaimed before the Sanhedrin. So get ready because your video starts now.
It's Kelly!
Hey!
What are we going to do today? We're going to learn and play.
Okay.
Sing a song and pray.
That's right.
God really loves us. God really, really cares about you, me, our families.
That's right.
God's always right there.
About taking steps to know God more, and also what it would be like in outer space and other galaxies far, far away. So, I looked up some fun facts about just that. Do you want to hear? Okay, here goes. Space is completely silent. Shh! Can you hear that? Yep, that's like space, but more silenter. Sunsets. That's when the sun goes down. On a planet called Mars are the color blue. You know how on Earth, our sunsets are like that orangey color? Can you imagine an entirely blue sunset? There are more stars in the universe than grains of sand on Earth. That's where we are. Crazy. There is a planet made of diamonds. Diamonds are those really sparkly things that people wear for jewelry. A spaceship has to go from sitting still, like this, to 18,000 miles per hour, like this, in 8 minutes to get into space. Whoa, that's really, really fast. Going that fast would be kind of scary. Do you think so? I was going to pretend to do a Cosmo Cali rocket launch and practice my G-force jiggy, but now I'm not so sure I want to. I've been pretending to do a lot of space stuff, just like astronauts do. But now I'm not sure I can. I mean, astronauts must be really brave to launch into space so, so fast. Then, once they're up there in space, they actually leave the spaceship and walk around in space. I'm not sure I would be brave enough to do that. Would you be brave enough to do that? Maybe your Bible story will teach you something about being brave.
It's time for today's Bible story, and it comes from the book of Acts, chapters 6 and 7. Stephen was a brave man who believed in God with his whole heart. Stephen was chosen to do an important job, to take care of the widows, the women who had lost their husbands. As he was doing that, Stephen did other unbelievable things for people. This was because he was full of God's power. Some leaders saw Stephen doing these things and they got mad. They thought Stephen had power that they wanted. Stephen knew it was God's power, and God gave Stephen words to say back to those who were mad at him. The angry leader had a bad idea. They got some people to lie about Stephen, saying that Stephen was speaking bad things. These lies spread, and Stephen got arrested. Stephen was brought in front of a group of judges. Stephen had done nothing wrong, but he said things to the judges that made the leaders even angrier. As they grew angrier, Stephen looked up and saw something crazy. He told the people that he was seeing Jesus standing right next to God in heaven. This upset them even more. They started throwing stones at Stephen. The stones hit him, and Stephen was about to die. But Stephen knew that he would be in heaven with Jesus soon. The Holy Spirit, which is like God inside of us, was with Stephen in every moment. So Stephen could be as brave as he cared for the widows, did unbelievable things for others, and even as he stood before those angry judges and leaders, Stephen was not alone. The Holy Spirit was with him. The Holy Spirit helped him. In the same way, when we believe in Jesus, the Holy Spirit is with us every step of the way. So we can take a big step. The Holy Spirit makes us brave.
That Bible story was really helpful. And I just saw the most amazing thing. Look at this picture of an astronaut walking in space. See that string-like thing? That keeps them attached to the ship. The that way, astronauts can explore space without getting lost or floating away. That's kind of like what the Holy Spirit does for us. The Holy Spirit is with us and keeps us attached to God all the time. Isn't that amazing? We don't need to be afraid. We can do anything, friends. The Holy Spirit makes us brave. Have you ever been afraid to do something or say something because you didn't feel brave enough? Or you were worried about what people might think?
Take a big step. The Holy Spirit makes us brave.
Okay, Cosmo Cali is ready for launch in 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Woohoo! This is Cosmo Cali signing off. Thanks for learning and growing with me. Peace out.
Hey guys, today in elementary, we're going to talk about how the Holy Spirit makes us brave. So get ready, because your video starts now.
Did you do it again?
Do what?
Oh, look, you know, arrange the string lights to show our next step, did you?
Guess I'll have to turn them on and see.
Yes!
What? We can do this, Jay!
No, I tripped again. You'd think I'd move that cord. And I'm Jay. Welcome to Press Play. Emma, why is it so hard to be brave?
Maybe because there are so many things to be scared of.
Like what?
Let's see. Things to be scared of. Here we go. Okay, acrophobia. That's a fear of heights.
Okay. Oh, no problem.
There's arachnophobia, fear of spiders.
Aw, he's kind of cute.
There's otophiophobia. That's fear of snakes.
Squirmy, wiggly, scaly. I love it.
There's astrophobia. That's fear of weather.
Oh, bring on the rain.
Wow, awesome, Jay. There's social phobia.
What's that?
It's fear of what people think of us.
Oh. No, not at all. That's not a problem.
Really?
Yeah. I'm not afraid of what people think of me. Should I be? I know I can be a little much. What have you heard? Have you heard something? Please, tell me. Tell me!
Whoa, Jay. I wonder where we can go and learn about being brave. You thinking what I am?
Why? What do you think people would think if I'm not thinking what you're thinking? Would it be okay? What if I am? What will they say?
Jay, chill. Let's do this.
3, 2, 1,
press play!
Where are we?
I'm usually the one who asks that, which basically means we're out there. Really out there.
You sure are.
Ooh.
Welcome to Borgon. Hi.
Hi. Thanks. Do you mind if I ask, who are you and what or where is Borgon?
Oh, yeah, great question. I'm Jen, the alien.
Really? You're an alien?
I know. Everyone expects like a million tentacles and stuff like that, all kinds of eyes, but nope. Here I am, just me, Jen the alien.
Oh, cool.
Borgon is a planet. Don't worry about where. That explanation would include light years and black holes and certain Taco Bell bathrooms.
I knew it!
Anyway, you're here. And just in time. You're Jay, right?
Yeah.
Awesome. We've been waiting for you. All the Borgonians have gathered to hear you tell them all you know about the human species, especially this Jesus guy that we hear so much about.
What? Me? Why?
I'm not sure. Borgonians always have their reasons. Anyway, you ready?
No!
Jay, you got this!
Well, what's wrong?
What if I don't know what to say? What if I can't say anything? What if...
Oh, wow. This reminds me of a story that I read in a book that I got from one of you Earthlings. It's called the Bible? The Bible?
The Bible?
The Bible,
yeah. The story came from a book inside of the book. Confusing much? The book was called Acts. Yeah, Acts, chapter 6.
An alien named Jen is about to teach us a Bible story. This is just a regular press play day, I guess.
Have a seat. So, now that you're seated, the number of people following this Jesus guy was growing fast. Jesus' original friends needed help to take care of all the needs of everyone. So, they chose 7 more people to help feed those who were being overlooked. One of them was named Stephen?
Stephen. I like that name. Was he an alien?
Not that I know of, but he was a special guy. The Bible says he, in Acts 6 through 5, he was a man full of faith and of the Holy Spirit.
Sounds a bit overqualified to be serving food.
Yeah, he kind of was. And he couldn't hide it. In Acts 6:8, it says he performed great wonders and signs among the people. This made him popular with some, but very unpopular with others.
Like who?
The members of the synagogue, for one. These were like the smartest of the smart people. And they didn't like people like Stephen because he challenged their power over the people. But when they argued with Stephen, the Holy Spirit made him brave and gave him words to say that they couldn't refute.
Wow. Cool.
Yeah, but they didn't give up. They hired people to say bad, untrue things about Stephen. So he was brought before the Sanhedrin. This was like the highest court, and he had to defend himself.
CJ, makes standing in front of some curious Borgonians seem kind of not that bad, huh?
I guess. Well, what did Stephen say?
Again, the Holy Spirit made him brave and gave him the words. Here was a man who was called to serve food standing in front of the Sanhedrin. They wouldn't like what he had to say because it would go against the way they did things. But he knew what we should know too. When the time comes, we can take a big step. The Holy Spirit makes us brave.
Oh, that's the big idea alarm. Jay won't be able to talk with the Borgonians.
Yeah, and I was totally ready to take that big step.
Hey, you still can. Borgon time can stop and start. I'll stop it now while you give your speech. The big idea alarm will still be going off when I start it again later. Ready?
Let's do it.
Whoa, Jay, you were incredible.
It wasn't me. It was the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit made me brave.
Time started again.
Oh.
Whoa.
Jen the alien, would you want to do the press play secret handshake with us?
Sure, sounds good. Whoa!
Where are you going?
The Taco Bell bathroom. I must know the truth.
Well, in review, we pressed play and made our way to the planet Borgon. There, we met the surprisingly normal alien, Jen. She shared with us about Acts chapter 6 and how the Holy Spirit made Stephen brave to share a message about Jesus. How can you trust the Holy Spirit to make you brave today? Take that big step!
And now it's time to...
Drop the verse!
Oh, what time is it, Emma?
I think it's time to drop the verse.
Already?
Ooh, I can't wait for this scripture! Here we go!
The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hand. Psalm 19:1. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hand. Psalm 19:1. The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of his hand. Psalm 19:1.
Psalm 19:1.
Hey guys, I hope you had so much fun worshiping with us and that you learned something new from your Bible stories.
Yep, and don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any updates from Pursuit Kids Online. We love you guys so much and we'll see you next week.
Bye guys.